everyone, and welcome to today's video. Today I will be checking out this Curlando calligraphy set, how it works, and how good it is for beginners, since I am one, and we'll see how it goes. I do write a good bit, but I'm not too great with calligraphy. I need to practice more, so we'll see how easy this set is to use. I opened it up before since I got it on my birthday, but didn't use it yet, so here we go. When we open it up, we can see the cards and envelopes for writing on, the selection of nibs to put on the pen, a bottle of ink, and lastly the wax seal with the wax. It also comes with an instruction manual, which should come in handy. The way you use this pen is by dipping the nib in the ink. You don't fill the pen with the ink, which is probably less messy to do, rather than filling it in from this bottle. What we do with the nib is just shove it in the hole. The nibs are different depending on the thickness and style of letters you're planning to write. Now I'm opening the ink. I thought it was black at the start, but it turned out to be blue ink. I definitely prefer black ink, but I'm not too fussy. What I have to do is dip the pen slightly in the ink. As I'm writing the first word, you can see how the ink goes paler as I write. Now look, I put too much ink and it created a blob. So you need to master the art of putting the right amount of ink on the tip. It seems easier than it is, to be honest. The thing is, if it's too much, it leaks out, and if you want to write a long word, the ink is not enough to finish, so you'll have to constantly dip it in, unless there's a certain technique for it. But it seems like it works if you do it quicker, instead of slowly and therefore letting more ink out than needed. This nib is not bad, I don't mind it. This one should be fine once I get the hang of it. I'll try out the different nibs and compare how they look and work by writing the same word underneath each other. Nib number one works just fine, it makes skinny letters. Next is nib number two, which has a broader tip. I'm dipping it in the ink, but for some reason it just doesn't want to come onto the very tip and onto the paper. After trying and trying and trying, it doesn't want to work for some reason. Nib number three is a flat, wide tip. The thick ones just seem to not catch the ink, I don't know why. Ah, there we go. Yes, this one works. It's harder to get the right amount of ink on it though. It was easier with nib number one. If I ever get the hang of it, I think this nib might be fun to use because I really like thick hand lettering. Still, it is a bit hard to get the ink on and off correctly, and you need a lot of ink to make it work. Nib number four has a little round tip on it. This one writes very smoothly, I like this one. And lastly, nib number five has a big round tip on it. The ink comes off, but what I find harder with these thick nibs is they obviously need more ink, so you'd have to dip it in more often. The ink then doesn't look evenly spread. I definitely prefer the skinniest tips, number one and number four. They're nice and I don't have to dip them in as much when writing a single word. It's cleaner, whereas the ones with the wide edge were harder. The ink stayed in the middle of it and would not want to sit down at the bottom of it, of nib number two. I have no clue why it didn't go out smoothly. And number three worked when I put tons of ink on it. Look at it, it's still glimmering here. Those are definitely my least favorite ones. This set is cheap, so I don't think you should expect something spectacular, but for a beginner, this will do for me. Not all the nibs are easy to use, but it'll do. We also have wax, and this is how the seal looks. I don't know much about wax, but all I know is I am excited to use it since it's not just normal candle wax. I used normal candle wax before and it isn't that great. It was just runny and messy and yeah. So I can't wait to use this one. In the instructions, we also have different fonts and how to do their strokes. And I like the box the set comes in so that everything is not all over the place. Here we go. I went through the product. I'd recommend it to beginners who have little money and really want something cheap. It's not a product where I'd go wow though. Still, it could be just my inexperience with these materials and calligraphy in general that makes it harder to use. Someone with more experience might be able to handle it better. This is just a small review from a beginner, not a pro. For other stationery reviews, make sure to check out my channel. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye bye.